Did I ask him to step down? No, I was in a conversation about getting things done. He is still the speaker now. We're trying to get decoupling done during this lame duck. And as I've said, the members of the House of Representatives are going to be voting on who their speaker is going to be. Yep. Well, let's start with certain are better than others. Certain of these incentives are better than others. That's one thing to take a account of. The second is that, you know, the Republicans are want to have it both ways, right? They want to claim that they want to demand cuts in state government, but they don't want to accept any that might affect constituencies that support them and write them checks. And so I would just say we've got to look at the entire state budget. We've got to look at expenditures for businesses, and we've got to look at expenditures for individuals. These are going to be painful cuts that get made. I am willing to talk to anybody about any of these cuts and have heard nothing from the Republicans about their ideas. But let's be clear, when they're fighting against some cut that I'm putting out there, what is their alternative? They have literally not put anything forward. Do I want to see what back on the ballot? Is that your question? That's not something I'm pushing for right now, but we've got to balance the budgets that are ahead of us. That's not something that can happen as a result of that. I'm sorry, this gentleman here. Well, I have favored passage of that bill since I was a candidate, since really before I was a candidate. And so, you know, that bill I know is coming to my desk, and I'll obviously take a serious look at it, but you know where I've stood for several years already.
Vaccines, therapeutics,
Bruce.
Members of the media here, back to the COVID, are we going to be in 1B because some of us have to go out and cover demonstrations we'd rather not be at? Some of us end up in rooms closer to each other than maybe we want to be. Where are we?
There may be other reasons for that, Bruce. Yeah.
Where are we?
Yeah. Well, you know, we've put out what our prioritization is for 1B. I'm sorry?
Are we going to have inmates?
Well, as you've seen, we've got 3.2 million people in phase 1B. What I have been very focused on is two things. One is lowering the age, because as you know, the people who have died most often from COVID-19 are those who are older. And so the age bracket that I put forward, 65 and over, covers a great deal of those. Second feature of the changes that I made is really a focus on equity, because we know that Black and brown communities have been ill affected by COVID in a way that others have not. And so by lowering the age itself, not to mention the categories of people who are covered, we are in fact effectuating equity. This gentleman back here. Well, we'll have to take a look at the final version of it. As you know, I have advocated and worked with the Black Caucus on many of the provisions. For a long time, even before there were these four pillars that the Black Caucus put forward in their agenda, and then as that began to take shape, we've been talking to individual members of the Black Caucus to make sure that we're helping them shape and coming up with ideas that I can favor in the process. But I am very much in favor of the process and the work that the Black Caucus has done overall.